In this video, I want to give you the best remedies to get rid of and prevent recurrent UTIs. UTIs, or urinary tract infections, affect more women than men, can affect both, but usually more women than men. And it's estimated that about 50% of women, they are gonna have a UTI in their lives. Usually the main treatment is antibiotics, and the problem is that we develop bacteria antibiotic resistance, so we end up with having recurrent UTIs. So in this video, I want to give you the best remedies, things that you can do at home to get rid of the infection and prevent the recurrent UTIs. So UTIs are usually bladder infections that are coming from fungus, yeast, or bacteria, usually E. coli is the most common. 90% of the UTIs are due to E. coli infection. And how this happens is because our urinary system is responsible for eliminating waste and responsible for establishing the balance between the water and the salt in our body. The waste is filtered through our kidneys, and the kidneys are connected through the ureters to our bladder, where we store the urine, and the urine is gonna be released through the urethra. So the bladder is usually sterile. There is not any single bacteria in there. However, there could be contamination through the lower part of the urinary system, the urethra, to the bladder, and it's how we get the urinary tract infection. And most common ways to get an infection is usually from bacteria like E. coli that is coming from our small intestine, or is also in the vaginal tract or around the urethra. So when it gets overgrowth and can enter to the bladder or even cause kidney infections. So some of the most common symptoms for UTI, a urinary tract infection, is when you have pain while you are urinating, or you have pain in your pelvic area or your back, that we sometimes say, oh, I have a kidney pain. Also, if your bladder is burning as well, if you have to go to urinate constantly, like several times within 1 hour, if your urine is cloudy, not as clean as usual, or if it's a little bit pink or red, that is already an indication for blood in your urine. Or if you end up having kidney infections, that could come from a UTI or a bladder infection. So usually some of the main causes or high risk factors to get a urinary tract infection is a pregnancy. Pregnant women usually have a higher predisposition, 10% of pregnant women, to get a UTI during pregnancy. Also, if we have been taking antibiotics, antibiotics are usually wide spectrum antibiotics. They don't only kill the opportunistic bacteria, but also the beneficial. So we do need a very diverse beneficial bacteria in our gut and in our body to be able to keep the opportunistic bacteria, yeast or fungus, in low numbers and prevent these infections or recurrent infections. So when we take an antibiotic, that is depleting the diversity of your microbes, so they are not able to keep those opportunistic microbes low, so then the chance of getting a UTI is also higher. Also, some percentage of the population, sexual activity, high sexual activity, can raise also the risk of getting UTIs. Age and gender. So as I said before, usually a UTI affects more women than men, but also the age. The age, when women get closer to menopause, or they go already through menopause, usually because the estrogen levels decrease, that affects also the diversity of the microbes in our vaginal tract. So we end up with lower number of beneficial microbes that are also able to maintain the opportunistic microbes in low numbers. So lower estrogen, higher chances of UTIs as well. And also because when we go through menopause, the bladder is losing the elasticity. So when we urinate, we may not be eliminating completely. So that increases the risk of UTIs as well. Also, if we have a suppressed immune system, the immune system is the machine that we have in our body to fight anything coming from outside or any microbe overgrowth that we have in our body. So if we are immune suppressed and our immune system is not working properly, we are not able to fight as well that infection that we may have in our blood or may come from the lower part of the urinary tract. So these are usually some of the most common. Actually, another one that I didn't indicate in here could be alcohol or a lot of caffeinated drinks, because that causes a lot of dehydration also in our body and a lot of liver problems, which cause also immune suppression. And dehydration also increases the risk of getting UTIs. So these are some of the major risk factors that are increasing the risk of them. But then we are able to prevent it, or we are able to revert it as soon as you get the minor sign, the minor symptom that we mentioned in here. Then you can, there are certain things that you can start taking that are going to help in decreasing the numbers of the bacteria, the fungus, or the yeast that is causing the infection in your body. So the first one, and it's one of my favorite when we are talking about E. coli infection, which, as I said, affects 90% of the UTIs are from E. coli. So D-mannose is a sugar that is, it doesn't spike your glucose levels, your insulin levels. And the good thing about D-mannose is that the residues from D-mannose are able to bind the E. coli and eliminate it. So this is one of the best supplements when we are talking about E. coli-based UTIs. Also, if it's bacteria, fungus, or yeast, some of my favorite antibiotics to get rid of it is oregano and clove essential oil and garlic. Garlic, you can take it in the raw form from the food by itself, but if you want it more concentrated, you can get allicin extract or garlic extract. Garlic is really rich in allicin, and allicin is the active compound that has the antimicrobial properties, but allicin is really unstable and really volatile, so the only way to get all the benefits from it, if you decide to eat garlic, is to eat it in the raw form. Don't cook it, the garlic, because otherwise you are eliminating the allicin. And then oregano, 2 drops, and clove, 1 drop, every 2-3 hours, as soon as you start getting the feeling of a UTI, 2 drops of oregano, 1 of clove, every, I would say 3 times a day, that would be beneficial to start decreasing the numbers and the growth of the bacteria, fungus, or yeast, because sometimes could be candida overgrowth. Vitamin C. Vitamin C, 500 milligrams to 1,000 milligrams in the morning, is one of the most beneficial supplements to boost your immunity. So your immune system is going to be able to fight that overgrowth of microbes. However, the vitamin C has been shown also to be able to acidify the urine. An unacidic environment in your urine is also decreasing the overgrowth of the microbes. So vitamin C every single day prevents you from having recurrent UTIs. Or if you start having any symptom, just start taking also about 1,000 milligrams of vitamin C. Probiotic that you buy from the counter, you need to have at least 30 to 50 billion bacteria and at least 10 different strains. The more diverse the probiotic that you buy, the more lactobacillus, the more bifidobacteria, the better to be able to repopulate the bacteria in your body and be able to boost immunity and fight and decrease the growth of the opportunistic bacteria. So you can take the probiotic from the counter, or you can take it in the form of fermented food like pickles, like sauerkraut, kefir. I prefer usually going for dairy-free kefir because that is more anti-yeast friendly as well, that if you have it milk base, but those fermented foods are a really good way to put really beneficial bacteria every single day to prevent also recurrent UTIs. And then drink as much as you can. Drink a lot of fluids, drink a lot of water, not because you are putting more water and then you have to go to the bathroom more often. That means you are gonna increase the symptoms of the UTI. When you drink a lot of water, you are gonna be able to flush out that bacteria or even the die-off of the microbe if we are taking any of these antibiotics. So a lot of water through the day. But then two of my favorite liquids that you can also put in your body every day or to start reverting those symptoms. One is raw apple cider vinegar. Raw apple cider vinegar has the mother in the bottom, is unfiltered, is a really good natural probiotic as well, but also helps in changing the pH of the urine to prevent the overgrowth of the microbe. The same way cranberry juice. Cranberry juice, if you buy it, if you don't make it, be sure you don't have any sugar on the label, because otherwise the sugar on that cranberry juice is gonna cause more microbes overgrowth. So be sure you buy cranberry juice with no sugar, or make your own with regular fresh cranberries, and that also changes the pH in your urine, but as well prevents the microbes from getting attached to the gallbladder. So it's preventing from the microbes to come in to our bladder and getting the UTI. So drink a lot of water to eliminate the die-off as well and eliminate the excess of bacteria. And then besides all of these supplements that you can start taking from the first moment you have a symptom, as soon as you have those symptoms, it's also very important that you stop having, for example, tight pants can cause a rash or any other problems that can affect the lower part of the urethra and then increase the risk of UTIs. I also recommend that as soon as you have to urinate, don't hold it. A lot of people, because they are at work and they drink a lot of water, they get really frustrated because they have to go to the bathroom often. But actually, that is a way to eliminate the waste in your body. Don't hold the urine, because otherwise that can increase the risk of getting UTIs and microbes overgrowth. Another one is stay clean and dry. And what I mean about that is that, mostly for women, as soon as we go to the bathroom to have a bowel movement, it's very important that we clean ourselves, but we do it from front to back, never from back to front, because in the feces we can release some of the E. coli that can cause UTIs. So if we clean from back to front, that can cause that the bacteria is gonna enter through the urethra and then cause a bladder infection. So every time you clean after a bowel movement from front to back, that is very important. And lastly is hygiene before and after sex, because sex, it was one of the risk factors that can increase the risk of UTIs. So try to urinate before and urinate after sex to eliminate all that bacteria that may be entering through the urethra at some point. So that is a really good way to prevent the UTIs during that. So these are some of the most important treatments and things that you can start doing to prevent UTIs, to get rid of it as soon as you have the first symptom, and also to prevent having recurrent UTIs, because these antibiotics are not causing bacteria antibiotic resistance. I hope all this information was helpful, and remember that you can subscribe to my channel to get more information every single week, and now you can get more in the next video.